Good evening and vanakkam. I'm Chennai Singapende, joining you live now from the beautiful district of Madurai. And over the next few weeks, in the run-up to the April 6th election, I'm going to be getting you a sense of what's happening on the ground here in beautiful Tamil Nadu. I'm also going to be getting you the latest from the poll-bound state of Kerala as well as Puducherry. So over the next half hour, expect the best ground reports that gives you a sense of exactly who's going to be winning this election. Before I get you those ground reports, here's the big story, the big political headline from the state of Tamil Nadu. The political war of words between Chief Minister Edappadi Palaniswamy and M.K. Stalin. The latest bone of contention is again over legacy, but this time it's Chief Minister Edappadi Palaniswamy hitting back at M.K. Stalin, raking up the issue of Karunanidhi. Now, what EPS has said to lash out at Stalin is that even when Karunanidhi was unwell, he did not trust Stalin with the leadership of the party. EPS has gone on to state, how are the people of the state supposed to put their faith, repose their faith in Stalin when his own father couldn't do that and make him the head of the DMK when he was unwell? Remember that this particular attack from the chief minister comes after M.K. Stalin time and again has spoken about the legacy of Jaya Jayalalitha. He's also lashed out at the AIADMK, referring to them as a slave party to the Bharatiya Janata Party. So you can clearly make out here that the battle for power has gotten personal now, with massive rallies being held by both sides. Both sides are also not shying away from lashing out on all issues in this election.
Stalin, திராவிட முன்னேற்ற கழக தலைவர், நல்லா சிந்திச்சு பாருங்க. திரு கருணாநிதி இருக்கின்றவர அவர் தலைவராக முடிஞ்சுதான் கட்சிக்கு. அவர் அப்பவே அவர் நம்பல. திமுக தலைவர் திரு கருணாநிதி அவர்கள் பேச முடியல, உடல்நிலை சரியில்லை, ரெண்டாண்டு காலம் வெளியிலே வரல, யாருக்கு அவரை காட்டல. அப்படி இருக்கிற நிலைமையில கூட ஸ்டாலினை நம்பி திமுக ஒப்படைக்கல. ஆக அவருடைய தகப்பனாரு, அவருடைய தந்தையே திமுக கட்சிய தன்னுடைய பயிற்சி ஒப்படைக்கல. நாட்டு மக்கள் எப்படி நம்புவாங்க? நம்புவாங்களோ? அப்பாவே நம்பாத திமுக தலைவர் ஸ்டாலின் தான். குடும்ப அரசியல் சொல்றாங்க.
Now, I've been travelling across the state for the last 1 week. I've not just been camped in Chennai, because I'm Singapende of the city, but also in other parts of the state. I also visited Kanchipuram, very, very close to the city of Chennai. Now, the first thing you think of when you think of the place Kanchipuram is their beautiful Kanchipuram silk saris. Remember that these saris are painstakingly made, hand-woven by weavers. It's a skill that's learned over years and decades of practice. So I spoke to these weavers. We've spoken time and again about vocal for local, put out the hashtags and the likes. Is that something that's really happening on the ground? Are the weavers thriving from such an initiative? I find out in this report.
Kanchipuram, the temple town just a couple of hours from Chennai, is home to a large weaver community.
This beautiful town is known for its architecture, its wonderful temples, as you can see, and also the Kanchipuram saris. Most people come down to this town either to see the temples or to pick up a handmade beautiful sari of their own.
These are the artisans who skillfully create Kanchipuram saris using gold thread and colorful hues sourced from Karnataka.
This is in Kanchipuram town, in a small village called Sevilamedu, where I've identified a weaver community. They've been doing this for decades and generations, hand-making beautiful silk saris for all of us and for our many, many occasions. So I'm going to visit one of these homes in this hamlet to understand the issues that weavers are facing and also how they so painstakingly make each of these saris. Let's go.
We make our way into a tiny house, through narrow corridors to a small room. Here, a weaver is hard at work, turning thread to sari. It's not an easy job, and it takes years to master the craft. Over the drone of a weaving machine, we hear them talk about how the government has failed them.
There. கல்வி கல்வி உதவித்தொகை கட் பண்ணிட்டாங்க, இயற்கை மரணம் கட் பண்ணிட்டாங்க, விபத்து மரணம் கட் பண்ணிட்டாங்க. எங்களுக்கு எந்த விதமான கொடுத்துருந்ததே கட் பண்ணிட்டாங்க. புதுசாக நாங்கள் சலுகை வந்து கேட்கல. கொடுத்த சலுகைகளை இந்த கூட்டுறவு சங்கம் மூலியமாகவும் தனியார் நெசவாளர்களுக்கும் எங்களுக்கு சுத்தமாக கட் பண்ணிட்டாங்க.
Like everybody else, the lockdown impacted these artisans too. They complained that when they had no source of income, they thought help would come from the government. But it did not.
எதுவும் கொடுக்கல.
காசு ஒண்ணுமே கொடுக்கல.
ஆ, எதுவும் கொடுக்கல.
இது வரைக்கும் ஆட்சி என்னமோ பண்ணிருக்காங்களா உங்களுக்கு?
எதுவுமே செய்யலையே. இந்த சொன்ன போல அந்த ஹாஸ்பிட்டலில் போய் பார்த்தோமா 5000 வரும். அதுக்கு முன்னே நான் கூட வாங்கிக்கிறேன். இப்போ அதுவும் கேன்சல் ஆகிடுச்சு. அது இருந்தால் கூட எவ்வளோ மேலே இருக்கும். போய் இப்போ பார்த்து இது பண்ணுமா, துண்டு வாங்கிக்கலாம் கவர்மெண்டில்.
At another weaver's workplace, we meet Murugan. He says he's been doing this for the last 46 years. Murugan thinks that his is the last generation of weavers. The hand-woven Kanchivaram story ends here.
எங்கள் வீட்லேயே 2000 பேர் நிச்சிருந்தாங்க, தொழில் செஞ்சாங்க. இதில் வருவாய் இல்லைன்னு சொல்லிட்டு தனியார் கம்பெனிக்கு போயிட்டாங்க, கொத்தனாருக்கு போயிட்டாங்க, ஆட்டோ ஓட்ட போயிட்டாங்க, பெயிண்ட் அடி போய்க்கிறாங்க. எல்லாருமே தொழில் செஞ்சுக்கு தான் குழந்தைங்க வந்து.
The weavers here feel the demand for Kanchipuram sarees has gone down because their product is expensive, and more people are now choosing to buy the cheaper machine-made sarees.
ஆனா இந்த ஜிஎஸ்டி மட்டும் கொஞ்சம் எடுத்துட்டாங்கனா இப்போ ஒண்ணுன்றதுல எல்லாத்துக்குமே ஜிஎஸ்டி போட்டு ரொம்ப க்ளோஸ் பண்றாங்க. இப்போ பாருங்க, எங்களுக்கு சரியான முறையில் ப்ரொடக்ஷன் இல்லை, தொழில் வந்து நெச்சி வரல, அதனால் இந்த கூலி ரொம்ப கம்மியாக இருக்குது. இந்த ஜிஎஸ்டியால் அதை கொஞ்சம் சரி பண்ணாங்கன்னா கவர்மெண்ட்டு நல்லா இருக்கும்பா.
While change is killing his craftsmanship, in his politics, Murugan, for one, wants to vote for change. He says he's fed up with both the AIADMK and the DMK.
நான் அமமுக தினகரன் குருபா.
ஏன் தினகரனுக்கு? ஏன்
தினகரன்னா இருக்கிற ரெண்டு கவர்மெண்ட்டுமே சரியில்லை. ஓயல்வாதிங்க, அண்ணா திமுக ஓயல்வாதி, திமுக ஓயல்வாதி.
More and more people are opting to stop their weaving business and choose to move into another sector, into another field. This perhaps is something we need to address to keep the culture, the tradition of Tamil Nadu alive, and to ensure that this weaving art form continues in the beautiful town of Kanchipuram.
What's happening in pole-bound Kerala? My neighboring state, Gopiyattan, is there. He filed this report from Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan's constituency to get your sense of what's the mood in Vijayan's stronghold.
Surrounded by rivers and water bodies, Dharmodam is a tranquil little village in Kerala. But the political temperature of this village is high. All thanks to the man representing this constituency in the upcoming Kerala Assembly elections. Dharmodam constituency is a result of the delimitation process in 2011. Since then, the constituency has always sent CPM candidates to represent them in the state assembly. In 2016, the constituency first caught the eye after Pinarayi Vijayan decided to contest in the elections after a gap of 20 years. Five years down the line, Dharmodam is in focus because it remains the sitting chief minister Pinarayi Vijayan's constituency.
This time around, with yet another elections round the corner, they are eagerly waiting for their candidate. this time it's a very special candidate, and that is none other than Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan. The people of this constituency call him with love Vijayan Chetan, or Vijayan the elderly brother.
They throng his campaign venues. Listening to his words, they break out into loud cheers at his punchlines. The Kerala Chief Minister's election routine is hectic. He begins his campaigning in the morning when he starts off from his home village of Pinarayi. And then he tries to reach out to every corner of his constituency. Hundreds of people gather at each location, where the Chief Minister would give a comparatively short speech, never more than 30 minutes. His focus mostly on the achievements of his government.
There is no doubt about the winning of Comrade Pinarayi. He will succeed. Everything was available here. No other problems. Even no other political problem or any other law and order problem or any problem was here. And living standard, it also increased.
As CM Pinarayi Vijayan swifts from one campaign to the other, we meet a party cadre of his who would easily catch anyone's interest. 28-year-old Linish says that he's a daily wage worker who has turned himself into a walking, talking campaign symbol. Across our journey in Dharmodam, we noticed that the social schemes of the current government was the hot topic of discussion and debate. With the LDF supporters singing paeans to the government, while the opposition alleged that pension and distribution of food kit schemes were nothing but an eyewash by the government. At our final venue, tracking CM Vijayan's campaign, we met Sujata. About 40-year-old, this lady drives a rickshaw to earn her living. She says she was among the first woman rickshaw drivers in the region. She says that during the lockdown, when there was no income, it was the free food kit that kept them alive.
It is precisely at this location in Parapuram, so that is the name of the locality in Pinarayi village, where Communist Party first took shape way back in 1939.
Dharmodam is considered a safe seat for the CPM, and for a reason too. Then Pinarayi Vijayan contested the seat in 2016, and he increased the margin to a mammoth 37,905 against the same candidate that the Congress put up. The LDF supporters say their interest in Dharmodam is only academic, because it is but a question of what the winning margin will be this time and nothing else.
I'm slipping into a very short break here on the special broadcast. Do stay with me. In a few minutes from now, I'm getting you two reports from the beautiful beaches of the south, from Puducherry and also the very famous and popular Marina Beach. Stay with me. I've got new reports from Tamil Nadu, from Kerala. Let's focus on the Union Territory of Puducherry, where the mood is upbeat. Election season is on. My colleague Nagarjun Dwarkanath caught up with some youngsters who were playing music to put out their sentiments on the upcoming election.
Maro maro chauka chakka song maro. Maro maro boys kail tumara.
Joining me now are a group of budding musicians to talk on this upcoming heated elections, both in Pondicherry and Tamil Nadu. How do you see these elections going forward?
I mean, in recent times, like for the past 20 years, there's been a switch in political parties. Like every time there's an election, and we had like strong leaders on both the sides. And this is the first time it's like both the leaders had a demise.
You are looking at individuals, or you still look at parties with cult figures which were there before?
Okay, so before Jayalalitha and Karunanidhi, we also had cult figures who were like ruling, and that's been like you have a top influential figure which the people can relate to. Usually when you watch a movie, it's the hero who takes like majority of the space, right? So relating to the film industry, in a band it's the singer, and basically the others support the band.
Tell me, should Rajini and should have entered politics or not enter politics?
The answer is straight. Should have. Are you a Rajini fan?
I am a Rajini fan.
Of course, we all are. Yeah. And apart from being a fan of his, of course, his intentions are good. He was always a good man.
And Kamal Hassan right now is contesting. You were telling me that he's from your constituency, Coimbatore South. Yeah. How do you see his chances? Should he have come much before, or shouldn't he have come? Now he's almost quit cinema, now he's completely into politics. How do you see his chances?
I think strike the iron when it's hot. I think now with both the strong leaders, like the cult figures that have gone, so people are looking for a new face to come in.
Why is the Tamil Nadu always have cinema people in politics, and they've succeed quite well? MGR, Jayalalitha, now Kamal and others too. It seems completely different from what Bollywood does.
If MGR succeeded, if Jayalalitha succeeded, it's also because of their, in each case we can see with respect to Jayalalitha, her power, the control that she takes over, and the good that she did to the people, that too matters.
What's your take on national parties trying to come into Tamil Nadu? They have never had any benefit or any result in this state.
Yeah, historically, and they have had no success. Like, they've tried to make inroads, but the localness of the Tamil Nadu people is like more, and they don't want like anti like national parties entering. They would not like it.
What do you vote based on this?
Health infrastructure is the main key, like to go to point, but it is not about just the health infrastructure. It's about how you get out and how you get the economy running.
Final question for both of you, my friends. If at all there's a concert of EPS and Stalin, who would you buy the tickets for?
You are basically asking us whom do you vote. So the answer to the question whose concert will we be playing is confidential.
But would you like to open for, if there's a political rally, would you like to open for EPS before his speech?
Who gives us big bucks?
So I was in Chennai the whole of last week, and how can I not visit the iconic Marina Beach? Hit by a pandemic, it hasn't really hit the mood of the people on the ground. Many, many vendors there, people, locals, tourists, all continuing to gather. And I had one question which I wanted answers to. Who are people voting for this time in the city of Chennai? Here's what I found. The iconic Marina Beach. A buzz 24/7 with locals, tourists and vendors. This stretch of sand and sea is the soul of Chennai. And amid a pandemic, it still comes alive every evening with lights, colour and sound. Marina Beach in Chennai is iconic for many reasons for the people of Chennai, for the people of Tamil Nadu. And you can see behind me one of those reasons. We are right in front of the memorials of Puraichi Thalaivar, Dr. MGR, and of Dr. Jayalalitha. And remember that this area is completely closed off, and yet you see so many people gathered here trying to just catch a glimpse of these memorials from outside, away from the barricade. You see the security presence there, and yet they're standing outside close to these barricades, many taking selfies, many, in fact, I saw so many of them standing here offering their prayers and their tributes to Jayalalitha, which is why we always talk about politics in Tamil Nadu being so very interesting, that it's very, very emotional, something that the people of the state are very, very invested in.
Chennai is a stronghold for the DMK. So it's no wonder that as we walk around Marina and try to gauge the view of these voters, their answer is a constant.
அதான் டிஎம்கே ஓட் பண்ணலான்னு இருக்கோம். அதான் முக ஸ்டாலின் வந்தால் கொஞ்சம் நல்லா செய்வார்னு கொஞ்சம் எதிர்பார்க்குறோம்.
சரி எடப்பாடி அவரை பார்த்துட்டோம், கொஞ்சம் தான் பண்ணுறாரு. சரி ஸ்டாலின் வந்தால் இன்னும் நல்லா பண்ணுவார்ல, பார்க்கும், அவருக்கு ஒரு வாய்ப்பு கொடுத்துப்போம்.
Ironic that standing right next to Jayalalitha's memorial, most of the locals say they want to give MK Stalin a chance to be CM and ensure the DMK wins this time.
We've spoken to you time and again about how politicians in Tamil Nadu enjoy a cult-like status, bigger sometimes than superstars. This is proof. You can get a picture clicked with Jayalalitha, or you can get a picture clicked with Kalyaniya Dr. Karunanidhi. And from what the people here tell me, the most popular cutout among all of these people is Jayalalitha. Symbolic, really, that we're standing right next to the Amma Memorial and people still throng these areas for that picture, that photo op with Jayalalitha. And that really sums up for you how adored, how loved these politicians were.
And this is Chennai Singapenne wrapping up this edition of The Bulletin. Thank you very much for watching. And do join me tomorrow at 6:30 as I get you some very interesting ground reports from right here, the temple town of Madurai. Thank you again for watching.
Hi everyone, Preeti Chaudhary here. Hope you like this video. For latest news and analysis, like and subscribe to the India Today YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thank you for watching.